Okay, given that we have understood the model of computation, now let's do some simple analysis, right, for both time and space complexity. First, we'll start with time complexity of insertion sort, right? So let me explain how to do that, right? This is the pseudocode that we have for insertion sort, right? It has 8 lines of code. Now, imagine that input A that I have, the array A, has a length of n. So a dot length, let's assume is equal to n, a variable n, right? This will make it easier. I don't want to write a dot length every time, right? So let's say a dot length equals to n, right? So the array that is given to us is of length n. Of course, n can be 10, 100, 1000, whatever number you want, any integer, right? Any positive integer. Now, having said that, when I'm running this loop, now let's go step by step. This for loop, let's say how many times would this for loop run? This for loop would run with j equals to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on so forth. Let's look at it. 2, 3, 4, so on so forth. N is nothing but a dot length. It'll also run for n plus 1 because when j becomes n plus 1, we will come out of that loop. Right? So this will keep getting, so the variable j in a for loop, it starts with 2. It'll keep getting incremented by 1. Right? Because we didn't mention anything, the default increment for this j is by 1. Right? So it'll go from 2 to 3 to 4 to so on so forth till n plus 1. When it reaches n plus 1, we know that n plus 1 is greater than a dot length and will come out of this loop. So how many times did this line get executed? If you think about it, if you just count this, right, it has been executed n number of times, right? So this is 1, 2, 3, so on so forth. If you do it, if you just count how many times this line was executed by my processor. Remember, I have a processor and I have a RAM. That is my simple model of computation, right? My simple model of computation is this, and all of my array A, which was given to me as an input, is already stored in my RAM. Right? So this line will be executed by my processor because we learned that processor executes code. But how many times does it have to execute line 1? It has to execute line 1 n number of times, right? As we have just seen, right? I'm just trying to simplify it for you. This is extremely important for you to get. So this line is executed n number of times. Now let's go to the second line. This line is executed only when we go into the loop, right? So this line is executed when j equals to 2, when j equals to 3, 4, so on so forth, when j equals to n. Because when j equals to n plus 1, right, we went out of the loop. We did not go into the loop. So this would run not n times, but n minus 1 times, right? Very simple, very straightforward here. So let me erase this and say n minus 1 times. So this line of code, this simple line of code is executed n minus 1 number of times. Now what about this? This is a comment, right? Comment, this comment also is executed n minus 1 number of times. Okay, I'll come to it. Now this line is also executed n minus 1 number of times, right? Just because all these are in the same loop. Now let's assume it takes, okay? So we'll come into the for loop, into this while loop in a little while. Okay, so since this is also outside the while loop, this is also executed n minus 1 times. We'll come to these, we'll fill these 3 steps. So there is this to be filled, this to be filled, this to be filled. I'll come there. First, let's understand the simple flow. Okay, so this outer for loop that I have, right? The for loop itself, this itself will run n times. Everything inside that will run n minus 1 times, except this complex while loop. We'll come to this while loop in a little while. Now let's assume it takes C1. Okay, let me write it more clearly. Okay, let's assume it takes C1 microseconds to run this line, right? Of course, there are different instructions, right? If you think about it, each of them is a different instruction. Different instructions will have different amount of time it will take to run this. Let's assume the cost, right, C1, because this is the cost or the time it takes to run this single line. Let's assume a C1 microseconds. For those of you who don't know what a microsecond is 10 power minus 6 seconds. Or in other words, it's 1 millionth of a second. Right? So similarly, this line 2, this will not take the same time as line 1 because it's a different, this is basically assigning a value from memory to your variable. This will take a different time as compared to this. So let's write it as C2. This will take, let's say, C3. This will take, let's say, C4. Okay, let's assume this takes C8. Okay, because it's the 8th line. Each of these commands will take different amount of time to be executed. Okay, so let's assume this was C1 microseconds, C2 microseconds. All of this is nice. At the end, what we want to do is sum up all of these. So the total time it takes now is C1 multiplied by N, right? Because this single line is taking C1 microseconds to run and it runs N number of times because my array length is N, right? That's why the total time it takes is C1 into N. Similarly, this line, it would be C2 into N minus 1. This will be C3 into N minus 3, right? Sorry, N minus 1. Sorry. So C4 into N minus 1. Similarly, here it will be C8 into N minus 1. Till here, everything is very good. No issues, no problems.